Hey friends, thanks so much for taking the time to explore your next step. You know, this past Sunday, we continued in our series called Graves and Gardens. And in this series, we're talking about heaven and hell and eternity. You know, during the first few weeks of our series, we're going to be talking a lot about heaven. And this week specifically, we clarified the focus of heaven. Now, let's face it. When we think about heaven, we tend to focus on us. At least I do. I focus on all the incredible things that I'll get to do and see in heaven. I focus on being able to see my mom again. I focus on how beautiful heaven will be. I focus on how sin will be a thing of the past. I focus on how heaven will just be this perfect paradise that is full of peace and contentment. And listen, while all of those things are true, you need to know that the focus of heaven isn't going to be on you or I at all. You see, the focus of heaven is on the glory of God. You see, it's the glory of God that makes any of those other things even possible in the first place. So this week, for your next step, why don't you begin each day focusing on the glory of God? You know, the Bible says this in Psalm 19, 1 through 4. It says, "The heavens declare the glory of God. The skies proclaim the work of His hands. Day after day, they pour forth speech. Night after night, they reveal knowledge. They have no speech. They use no words. No sound is heard from them. Yet their voice goes out into all the earth. Their words to the ends of the world." I love that passage. Think about it. If the stars and the skies can proclaim the glory of God, how much more should we showcase the glory of God in our lives? So this week, what if every morning and every night, you and I, we looked out into God's creation for something that shows off the glory of God? It could be a bird singing early in the morning, doing what it's been created to do. Or it could be the moon at night giving light in the midst of the dark skies as it does what it was created to do. I mean, it could even be the rain that God sends that waters the earth just like it was created to do. You know, this week, why don't you look for some ways that you can give glory to God by doing what you were created to do? Such as worshiping God, our Creator, and serving Him by serving other people and telling people about the glory and greatness of God. So this week, rather than focusing on yourself or your circumstances, focus on the glory of God. And when you do, notice how focusing on the glory of God begins to change the way that you view everything else in life as well. Have a great week.